Science Safety.
Professor Gerald Stevens, and this is the Safety of Science. Now, you all got a safety contract when you started the class. It goes over all the rules you need to abide by in a science lab. Not abiding by these rules will get you killed. Now we're going to go over each and every rule and what situations you need to use them in, why you need to use them, and so on and so forth. Safety goggles. You need to be worn at all times when dealing with anything that can get in your eye and mess you up. With your safety goggles on, pretty much nothing can mess with your eyes. But if your safety goggles are off during the lab, well... That had to hurt. Another really important rule is knowing where the stuff in the room to take care of any incident is. You've got your safety shower. Make sure you know where this is in case of an emergency. And safety eye wash. This is what you use to wash your eyes. Don't use a sink. You're not going to get it right, and it's not going to help your eyes at all.
Oh, I think I got some in my eyes. Oh. Which one do I use?
What that student should have done is he should have used the emergency eye wash to collect whatever chemical he got in his eyes out, and he should have been wearing his safety goggles to begin with. Another very important rule you need to keep an eye on. Food and drink. Keep them away from your lab area. Next thing you know, you're going to be chugging down the hydrochloric acid, and we all know where that's going to go.
Oh man, I'm thirsty.
Such a tragic way to die, but for being so stupid, he probably deserved it. Another important rule is to make sure that you follow all directions carefully. Directions are your commandments, they are your testaments, they are important, and they will keep you from screwing up. I one time knew two lab partners didn't follow directions on a very important lab, and now half the state of Ohio is.
We should totally mix these.
Ah, dude, I don't know. The directions say do not mix.
Directions are always right.
That young man should have listened to his stunningly handsome lab partner. Now, that's just the kind of mistake you can't make up. Do you want to be responsible for blowing up half the state of Ohio? I didn't think so. Follow the rules. Another rule you need to make sure you remember. No horseplay. No goofing off. It's a science lab, not a place to... horseplay and goof off. You know, if you behave in a frantic and bohemian fashion, someone's gonna get hurt. Do you mind?
Yeah. Jerk?
Ow!
Guys, quit goofing around in lab.
Sorry.
Horseplay is dangerous, and someone is bound to get hurt if you act like a moron in your lab. But yardsticks aren't the only way to get yourself hurt. You could electrify yourself in some kind of socket, or hit your head on a sink, or laser pointers. These things are really dangerous. You never know when you're going to shine in somebody's eye. That's a clear example of how laser pointers are going to get you hurt. Could someone call an ambulance, please? Thank you. Another very, very important hazard you need to keep an eye on is fire. Now, there are many ways to get hurt in a lab, but fire is really going to mess you up. Well, it's fire. I don't need to explain why fire is bad. Now, when a dangerous fire incident occurs, a fire blanket located in this room behind that television is what you would use to put out a person. You would cover them in the blanket and smother the fire. Well, if you don't know what to do, you're going to look like a flaming moron, as this student did.
Yeah, make sure you're careful near that Bunsen burner, okay?
I'm sorry. I can't help but laugh every time I see that. Another thing you need to keep in mind when you're in your lab, tell your teacher everything. If something goes wrong, you need to notify your instructor immediately. You ignore something, ignoring things isn't going to make any problems go away. So ignoring an incident in the lab is definitely going to make things worse. Dude, you got some random liquid on your arm. Don't you think you should tell the teacher?
What could possibly happen?
You say sit down, it's just dark. Smile politely back at you. You stare politely around you. Some sort of window to your right.
As you can see, not notifying your teacher of any hazardous event is going to cause you to lose an appendage. A leg, a head. You don't want that to happen, do you? So tell them. You never know what kind of dangerous event is going to ensue if you don't get some kind of teacher supervision. I'm Professor Gerald Stevens, and this has been the Safety of Science. I hope you're educated, and I hope you keep safe, so none of that stuff happens to you. Otherwise, you'll be a one-eyed, one-armed, on fire. Hobo. Not really. That would be bad. I don't care who you are, it's just not a good place to be in. Okay, go blow something up.
Relax, don't do where, when you wanna go to where. Relax.